Yes, you beautiful souls, welcome back at another installment of the Culinary Hotline Blue! Ching, ching, ching!
Yes!
I love this time in the morning. Now we are joined by our resident, our favorite, it's Clem Chef. And if you have any questions for Chef Clem on all things in the kitchen, then call us right now on 021-110-5552. Chef Clem, lots of stuff happening this morning, of course. I see a lot of ingredients out here in the kitchen. What are we doing?
We are first going to talk about more microwave stuff.
Okay,
Last week was pretty amazing. And have you noticed you've been in the kitchen a lot lately?
Yeah, I'm enjoying it, man. I'm getting
Chef
educated.
Ryle Chef, just owning it. Okay, so let's talk about popcorn.
Hey, let's not talk about
popcorn.
We got a call on the line. Let's shake and bake. It's the spring dance. Culinary Hotline, Bring, how may I help you? Hello, who may I ask
you
speaking? Hi.
Hi.
Who's speaking?
Beauty.
Good morning, Beauty. How are you doing?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm fantastic. What's your question today in the Culinary Hotline, Bling?
I want to know how to do chicken mayo.
Chicken mayo. Oh, that is a good meal. I also want to know that, so thank you so much. Chef Clem, what do you got for Beauty?
I think Beauty's planning all the picnics. You know, it's springtime, she wants to get outdoors. Chicken mayo is an amazing picnic. Like,
yes.
Just make it and take it. I love that dish. So I've got an amazing hack for cooking chicken breast. Chicken breast notoriously will just go dry. You will look at it and it will go dry.
Yeah.
So here's a good one. What you're gonna do is pot of water, and we're gonna flavor the water. We're gonna season the water, make it super aromatic. Bay leaves. Bay leaves in everything. Just put bay leaves in everything.
Okay.
Everything. Just do it. Right. Bay leaves go in, garlic goes in. You can slice it up if you want to.
All right. And this just is getting chucked into the water right now.
Right. It's gonna come to a boil, and then what's gonna happen is I normally do this from cold, so I put everything into the pot at cold, and then as it gradually increases in temperature, it extracts so much more flavor.
Okay.
But if you want to save time, just get
just
the water
get it
and
in.
Add it in.
Right.
Peppercorn's very important, and then salt.
Some salt.
Also very, very important. Without salt, this recipe does not work.
All right.
Not at all. Okay, cool. Salt goes in. What you're going to do, here's where you got to have faith.
Beauty, are you still on the line? Are you still listening,
Still there, Beauty?
Okay.
She's there.
Cool.
Yeah, she's
so what
there.
You're gonna do? You're gonna bring this up to a boil, okay?
Yeah.
Like a proper boil. You want a year going.
Right. Yeah.
You add the chicken breast to the water, and here's where you gotta have faith again. Okay. As soon as you add the chicken to the water, turn the heat off. Put the lid on. Forget about it for 15 minutes.
What?
Graham in the background. Graham's like,
everybody's, what the horror, the shock. Okay, but you're saving electricity, so I'm liking this. Why?
Yeah, in that 15 minutes, there's enough heat in the water to cook the chicken all the way through. Mm. And because it's gradually cooking, it locks in so much moisture in the chicken breast. I'm telling you.
And it doesn't dry it out.
It does not dry out.
Wow.
It does not dry out. And then if you want to know, what do I do with the water afterwards? Because you poached the chicken in there, use the water to make like a soup or something.
Like
it's got flavor in there, yeah.
Okay,
so
for one.
That's how you make a chicken breast. And what I like about this recipe is you can multiply it as many times as you want. So if you're doing like big, like batch cooking for like a lot of people.
Well, people like me, maybe.
For you, the protein. Just bigger pot, more water, chicken breast, literally chicken in, lid on, 15 minutes, forget about it. Then you take it out.
That's cool. Okay.
So, okay.
Right. Still with you?
Chicken mayo. I've got mayonnaise, I've got chives, so a little bit of like a savory flavor, mm-hmm. chives, mustard.
Okay.
It just cuts through things. It just makes things so much richer. You just taste more of it. So pepper and salt. Can you make that for me?
I got you. All right. So we've got mayo and all the good stuff in here. And this is going to be like bougie mayo, essentially, right? For our chicken mayo.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Right.
So you can either shred the chicken, which is fine.
Okay.
But I like when I make a chicken mayo, I like to actually see the chicken
you
in the chicken
chunky,
mayo.
Yeah.
Keep it chunky.
Get a nice chunky bite in there as well.
So nice and just like chunky, like you said. And another thing is if you do make, we spoke about this offline. If you make chicken breast, okay, and you're not gonna mix it into the sauce, but when you put it in the fridge, make sure it's properly covered with like plastic wrap.
Yeah, because I find like everything I put in the fridge, even if it was medium rare, the next day it's just dry as
the
ever.
Chicken is a dehydrator. And it just takes the moisture out of things. So if you're gonna keep this for the next day, make sure you really properly cover it.
Okay.
My tip is to actually just mix it into the sauce first, then pop it into the fridge.
I've got to say, Beauty, thank you so much for asking this question, because not only have I learned how to make chicken mayo, but I'm learning how to make mayo. I'm learning how a different way to make chicken as well and get these new recipe inspirations. So thank you. And Beauty, thank you for this question. So many hacks coming through on a Culinary Hotline Bling this morning. I love this one.
Here's my thing. Chicken mayo. Mm-hmm. It sounds like a simple thing. Chicken mayo, you know.
Chicken and mayo.
But you can make it so much fancier if you actually toast some brioche bread, put the chicken mayo in there. Then it becomes, right. Then it becomes like proper, like, you know, we're doing something special here. So amazing mixing skills, next level.
Yeah, yeah.
We got and some brioche bread.
Beauty,
like
if you are still on the line, then what we also have for you is the opportunity to check all the ingredients, all this recipe inspiration on expressoshow.com. And of course, if anybody's just tuned in now, shame on you. But don't worry, we got you covered.
Wow.
We're busy making something spectacular. It's chicken mayo buns. Beauty has called in to ask us how to make the best, and we are out here to deliver with Chef Clem, of course. He's about to toast, is it called brioche bread?
Brioche bread. So we know brioche yes. buns, right?
Yes.
Willie's now solved the bread, which is just like
hey,
next level.
Guys.
Spring is the season for brunches, and when it comes to brunch or breakfast, brioche bread is where you go. So this is an amazing one that you have to do. So, it doesn't take long to toast. You'll see.
I've got to say,
look at the color already.
It's that looking like restaurant quality. It's something that I'd order in a menu somewhere. Well done.
It's how we do.
This
honestly,
how
honestly.
We do.
Okay, Beauty, this one is dedicated to you. There we go. Chicken mayo sandwich. Done. I'm telling you, this chicken mayo is not like a normal chicken mayo that you taste because the chicken is so tender, so delicious, so juicy, and you can only get it by doing that poaching method. Don't try roasting it.
Beauty, you absolute beauty. Thank you so much for coming through with that question. I hope we answered it all, and I hope the rest of Mzansi was listening too because that was quite informative. That was like three hacks in one at the same time, yeah.
I try.
You do try. But we were
the
talking
popcorn.
About the popcorn.
Okay, so back to last week on the microwave. So one of my biggest hacks when it comes to the microwave is microwave popcorn that you don't have to buy. You can just make it at home.
Okay.
And it never fails. So you get South Africa's favorite ice cream. This is a good one because you actually have to go and buy tin roof ice cream from Willy's. I mean, South Africa is obsessed with it.
So you've got more incentive to finish the tub
right,
now.
Right, because you need the tub. That's what you need. So 2-liter tub, and it works with a 2-liter tub. Don't try using the 5-liter tubs. I found that the popcorn doesn't really pop that well in the bigger tubs, and I think it's because of the amount of heat that builds up in a smaller tub. So, 2-liter ice cream container.
Wait, you're talking like we're gonna heat the stuff in the tub.
What? You are.
Wait, what?
You are.
Okay, I'm listening.
I'm telling you, it's gonna change your popcorn like game forever. So, baking paper. Don't use wax paper. It's gonna start a fire. Baking paper. There's a difference. Okay, wax paper, obviously wax lined. You don't want to heat that up in the microwave. Make sure the popcorn seeds, no. Baking paper, cool.
Baking paper, not wax paper.
So you line the inside with the baking paper, then popcorn seeds. And all you're going to do is you're going to add it.
I'm so confused. I'm like, what's going to happen? How are you going to heat the... This doesn't make sense. I'm like, are you going to put the tub on the plate and then the plastic's going to melt? You put it in the oven, the plastic's... I don't understand.
Lid on, but you make sure like the one corner is just open a little bit.
All right.
Cool. Microwave, 2 minutes. Okay.
All right.
So the baking paper stops the plastic from melting because it insulates the heat.
Okay.
Things start happening in there.
Yeah.
And it's a better way to not burn popcorn seeds. So like this, I should have told you about this pre-winter while you were chilling watching movies.
You just left us to eat cold popcorn.
I'm sorry, guys, but this is how you do it. This is absolutely how you do it. It works every single time.
That's pretty cool. Okay, so now I understand why the 5-liter doesn't work because it might not even fit into the microwave to start with.
One, yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And then obviously, like I said, the fact that it needs that heat to build up to actually get the popcorn to pop.
All right, okay.
You like that one?
I love that one, man. Thank you.
Okay.
Listen, we got a lot of questions also about what I believe was, I think it was you and G last week, we're actually doing some stuff in the microwave.
Right.
We had some questions coming through as well. I actually got some here which I wanted to check out. The first one was actually from Diane Roman. She wants to know, why when I make fudge, does it always come up, when I make it in the microwave, why does it turn out and come out like toffee?
Okay.
So why does it go solid fudge, makes it in the microwave, and then it turns to toffee?
Microwaves have different strengths, which I've found out recently while I was testing recipes for these microwave segments. So what you want to do is you want to check the wattage on a recipe when it comes to a microwave recipe, and they actually give it to you. So the thing is, you're probably caramelizing your sugar before the mixture's actually cooking properly.
Okay.
So number one, make sure you mix the ingredients really well. And then number two, just check the wattage on the recipe and what your microwave wattage is, because you might need to, and microwaves do this. I didn't even know my microwave also does it. You can turn down the power.
What?
Right?
Say what?
You know when some microwaves have the old school ones?
Yeah.
They go low, medium, high,
okay,
defrost.
Okay.
Turn it down, because sometimes what happens is your microwave's too powerful. It's like, wow, I mean, just too powerful.
Sorry, Clem, I can't help it.
And you caramelize the sugars too quickly. So that's another one. Microwave Fudge is also a notoriously tricky one to get right. So it's practice. It needs practice as well.
Practice makes perfect. Practice gets you hacks like that. The popcorn's popping, so while we get to that, that is unfortunately all the time we have for the culinary hotline. Bling! Ting, ting, ting! And thank you all so much for joining us. I hope you were entertained, educated, and of course, the belly will be fed. Popcorn time!